Okay, welcome to the Solid Solutions webcast series, giving you an insight into the capabilities of SolidWorks. This is the third in the series highlighting the creation of 2D drawings. Here we've got the SolidWorks part model. If you want to see how this was created, you can go to our part modeling webcast, which is also available online. So all we're going to do is pick a standard template or drawing border. These are templates you can customize yourself to put in your own company standards for dimensions and text and that sort of thing. And SolidWorks will give us a nice view palette here showing us all the standard views, and it's simply a case of dragging and dropping those views onto the drawing sheet. We can refine those views a little bit by putting on things like hidden line detail. Maybe I don't want hidden lines on this particular view. Maybe on this view I'll have a nice shaded view of the model. It really helps engineers and non-engineers understand what it is they're looking at straight away. So the next thing we want to look at is dimensioning. Now I can put on dimensions manually. But I can also, as a quick start point, I can bring across dimensions I've used in creating the model so far. So let's call across some of those dimensions, and I can control what dimensions come across as well. For example, I could say, well, just bring across the dimensions of that feature and maybe that one as well. So we can control what comes across. A stage on from that, I can put on dimensions that are relevant to a particular view. So I'll bring across all the dimensions relevant to this right hand view here. And you can see that throws on all those dimensions quite nicely. Now we can go ahead and start moving these dimensions around and repositioning them to exactly the right places. And on this radial dimension here, for example, I want the arrow to go to the inside of the arc. So just by clicking on that dimension, it automatically brings up the dimension menu. So I don't have to go and find it anywhere. It's true for anything in the drawing environment. You click on it, it gives you the right menu. So it's a great tool to learn, very easy. We'll just do the same thing with this radius down here. Now this particular radius, maybe I want to just put a little jog into the dimension line here, just so I can get right in and dimension it exactly where I want to go. So you can see it's very quick and easy just to start getting exactly the right dimension styles you want. I could start or finish this off by dimensioning features manually. It's one dimension tool for all types of dimension. It just looks at what you're selecting and gives you the right dimension style. So here we've got an angular dimension just by picking two lines at an angle. What we can also do now is put on a section view, and again it's so much easier than creating a section view in a 2D CAD package. We just draw the line where we want the section and place the view down. Here I want to get rid of the hidden line details on here, and now maybe I want to create a detail view. Again, all I have to do is to draw that circle on there, and there it gives me the detail view. And again, I don't have to fix to that position. As I start moving it around, you can see it's updating in there. We can change the size, but just by selecting that detail view, again the detail view menu appears, and I can ask for things like a full outline maybe. And maybe we'll change the label to be Z instead of B, and it gives me all the scale dimensions and things on there as well. If we look at the bottom right, we can see that SolidWorks has also populated the title block for us with all the information from the model. So we've got the title, the material, the description, the weight, the scale, and again this is all modifiable. So we can go in and maybe change the description, and that will change the description of the part as well, so when that's used in a bill of materials, the right description will come up. So when you look at how long that's taken me to create this 2D drawing, it really is one of the strengths of SolidWorks. It's far quicker to create 2D drawings in SolidWorks than a 2D CAD system. But it's also very quick to modify as well. If, for example, we want to change the width of one of these lugs here, I can change that from within the drawing. So if I say this is going to be 35mm long instead, you can see that just within seconds I've updated this whole model. Okay, another way where we can speed up the drawing creation process is using something called the DIM Expert. So we've got our SolidWorks model here, but this could in fact be an imported model from another CAD system. And I can put on here at the 3D modeling stage a manufacturing dimension scheme. Just by selecting the various datums that I want to dimension from, I can ask SolidWorks to go away and, using some standards that we put into the system, it will put on there general tolerances. It can include geometric tolerancing as well as standard dimension tolerancing. And there we've got our dimension scheme. What it's also doing is it's checking that it's got enough dimensions to make that shape as well. So by turning on this button here, if I see all the faces color coded in blue, it means that there's enough dimensions to make that shape. If I delete one of them, maybe I don't like this dimension, it's not what I want, I can just simply delete it, put another one on from this face, and this time we'll dimension it from the bottom face. And now we'll do a quick check, and that still is okay now. We've sort of slightly altered the dimensioning scheme. Now to produce a 2D drawing of that, very simple, as before, we can just open up a drawing sheet and drag the models in there, and you can see automatically it puts those dimensions on there. So we can just tidy that up a little bit. Within a very short time frame, we've got a fully dimensioned drawing. Well, I hope this gives you a brief insight into how easy it is to create drawings in SolidWorks, and I hope you found it useful.